Capricorn. Let's jump into it and have a look what's coming up in regards to love for the sign of Capricorn. Okay, there's definitely a new chapter in love coming up for some of you or a new person. I feel like aces bring about new people, new events, new kinds of relationships or new phases in relationships. So that's a very good sign here. I feel it follows suit to the theme of progression that's coming forward here, okay? Ace of Wands, Hand of God, it's divine intervention on your behalf. The Wands being a very optimistic time to act on something, okay? It can be a fire sign coming in, and if they are, they're coming in fairly quickly. The Tower card, the Devil, and the Ace of Wands tells me that there might be a physical connection coming in around you that might linger or might develop into something more, or a physical attraction is going to grow in very powerful ways. There's also a possibility for one-night stands, which can end up into relationships as well, okay? The Ace of Wands can be a phallic symbol here. The Lover's card, sexual connotation here as well. And then the Tower card. Okay, Tower cards are shake-ups, breakthroughs, revelations, secrets, things that are exposed. It could even be fights or conflict. It's fueled by fire here, and fire, okay, being conflagration, consummation, consuming something, something coming up into flames here, something that's being ignited. So something that's being ignited here in terms of that might result in an argument. That might result in a passionate affair perhaps, or something that's being ignited here, okay? It's almost like you're turning on the fire, the furnace, and it's going to be hard to turn on. So be careful what you're unlocking here, Capricorn, because it could unleash a lot, okay? It could definitely open up a can of worms here. So whether it's you that's instigating this or another person, I thought I wanted to mention that. But we need those tower moments sometimes, okay? Something that you wanted to build up will come crashing down for some of you. It's going to be quite puzzling with the Seven of Cups. Emotionally, it might leave you a little bit disorientated. And then you'll have to pick up the pieces and move forward in a situation. And whichever way that means, either going separate ways or reconnecting with someone, that's something that could happen for a lot of you Cappies watching. It could be that you're very fixated on a situation, okay? Page of Pentacles, he doesn't see or hear anything else. In fact, he's just observing this pentacle here. There is definitely someone here who might be doing a bit of stalking or keeping tabs on you, Capricorn. It might be someone you've had this falling out with. It might be someone that you knew quite briefly, okay, the pleasure seeker, so to speak. It might be someone who's made an impression on you, someone that you work with, that you've been on a date with. But they're, it's almost like they're watching what you do. You might even work with this person. Could be an earth sign here, fellow earth sign. You did have Capricorn, Cancer, Aries. Could be one of these signs, but I feel like the page is someone who has a very strong physical attraction to you, and they're very inspired. There's a certain intensity in the way they look at you, approach you, talk to you. So I guess pay attention to these verbal and non-verbal cues from the people around you if you are wanting to see who this person is that's got their eye on you. But the Page of Cups is a new attraction that's forming for a lot of you, okay? I always see it as a very strong focus or energy that's being diverted to something here. So if there's an issue here that you want to talk about with your partner, with your special person, if there's something that's been playing on your mind, there might be an opportunity here to lay it all out on the table here, okay, as the Magician does. Again, it's quite a fast-paced energy, so I don't feel like, for some of you, you're not dragging something on. It's going to happen fairly quickly, but there is some sort of continuation, like somehow it's going to linger in one way at least. But the good thing about the Three of Pentacles is that it is a card of persuasion. It is a card of negotiation, of sacrifice, and trying to get one's point across. Building solid foundations. You can see the pillar here as well that make or contribute to a larger journey or a larger cause or reason, the three being a tripartite energy of birth, life, death, beginning, middle, ending. So it is a major journey that you're engaging in. There's a chapter, romantically, there's someone that's a chapter, or, you know, it's a page in your book, they're a chapter in your book, they could be the whole book, but there's something of value in your relationships. It's somehow going to leave its mark on you, whether it's learning a lesson, whether it's committing deception, whether it's having deception brought upon to you, whether it's learning about how to really read people, learn about what you'll tolerate and what you won't tolerate in relationships or marriages, or when dating and filtering people through. There's a bit of a learning curve for a lot of you, okay? With the Seven of Cups, there could also be fantasy or wishful thinking. For the most part, it can be like you wanting to achieve some sort of goal, or you want your dream person to be a certain way, or maybe they haven't been acting like themselves and you're wondering why, and you want to go back to that phase when things were very beautiful and developing. But there's a bit of dreamy energy. I don't know if someone's going to put you in a dreamlike state, make you feel dreamy. You might be daydreaming about them, you might be fantasizing about them. Or again, the roles are reversed and this is the same person who's fantasizing about you in a lot of different ways, in a lot of different positions. Capricorn, God only knows what's going on in their mind, but there is someone who is emitting that sort of attraction or desire for you in this month. So I guess it'll be a lot of, it'll be a very interesting. Let's move on and have a look at your career. Or business, finance, anything that sort of comes up around those areas for Capricorn. Okay, Taurus is coming in for some of you, Hierophant. Taurus is good. Taurus brings ownership and money, recognition. The Hierophant is all about status. Some of you, your status is changing in the workplace, okay? You've got Taurus and Gemini energy. Okay, so Taurus is quite powerful, quite commanding. But look, the Hierophant is quite influential. So if you are meeting this person of importance, it could be the Hierophant. There could be the board of directors coming into your company. There could be someone who, the company owner, the founder, the CEO, the district manager, someone of importance that might be working very closely with you, or you might come into contact with them a fair amount. But could also be changes to your status, because the Hierophant is elevation. He elevates these monks, inspires them, leads them. So for a lot of you, there's potentially management or promotional opportunities that could be around you. So pay attention to what's around you, because your luck is changing in terms of career, and you do have the beautiful Nine of Cups, which symbolizes wish fulfillment, a wish coming true, a dream coming true, fulfilling a goal, having things falling into place, things aligning very nicely, whether it's signs, symbols, synchronicities, deeds, a course of actions, a chain of events, a sequence of events that might be playing out in a very gobsmacking, crazy way. Okay, maybe a little bit unexpected, but good for the most part. It'll have you feeling great. Also, there's a destined Gemini potentially around you with the Lovers card. You might be meeting a soulmate, twin flame through your career, or your career is going to connect you to the people that you need to be connected to. The angel, he personifies the universe at large, law of attraction, a religious deity, you know, whatever it is that you believe in, a higher self. But there's something that's orchestrating a very important meeting, okay? If this is a job interview, there's success. Your communication is your strong point here, the way you communicate, the way you organize things, the way you express yourself, the way you promote yourself and exhibit your skills, etc. That is your strong point, or that is a point of focus for you in regards to career or creative pursuits, whether it's communicating with your team, communicating with co-workers, managers, clients, employees, employers. Communication is key here. Okay, this is the Gemini. A lot of information going to be coming in around you as well. Gemini energy is very buzzed, okay? It's all about communication. It's all about intellectual stimulation, seeking answers, getting clarification and validation. So that is going to be important. That might be where your focus lies. And that needs to be your strong point, because the Page of Swords is here, okay? Areas where you've lacked confidence, or you haven't been able to progress, or there's been a block, for example, writer's block, that's about to change, okay? He looks almost enviously at the Lovers, okay? He wants to be there. But the thing is, He's swords. He can make it happen. He just chooses not to. His attitude prevents him from flourishing, prevents him from getting those creative juices going, prevents him from finding inspiration in what's around him. So there's always ways, Capricorn. But look, there could be a bit of a dip here, and the dip would be the Five of Pentacles. It is earth energy, and it can point to financial hardship or despair. Okay, it can be you being in a position where you don't have enough resources. You might have to do a little bit more research. You might not have resources, funds, and there might be that things are in a little bit of a standstill here. Could also be sponsorship or charity opportunities, fundraising opportunities, or you might have to think about innovative ways to help bring more resources, more money, more capital into something that you're undergoing. Could be a thing where money is tight and there might be something that you need to fix or invest in or rectify, and that might require funds. So it'll come unexpectedly though. So be prepared, because the Wheel of Fortune can really throw a lot of things at us at a lot of different times, as can the Magician. And you have that energy around you this month, so that could definitely lead to those sorts of things. So I guess keep an eye out on what that could be. Or it could be an earth sign that's coming to you for help. It could also be anything to do with health, okay? There could be very stressful periods. And, you know, and the devil is temptation. The devil is someone needs to assert power. And it can cause a bit of a power struggle. And that's where one person is sitting pretty, sitting up top, and the other person is feeling underwhelmed, overworked, or not the same position as the devil, for example. So for a lot of you, there is a bit of a power struggle potentially in the workplace with either yourself and another person or with someone else. But if you are involved in sponsorships or have some business collaborations or signing of contracts, this is a very good sign to have the Lovers, because it could indicate good communication and a strong union that's going to stand the test of time. Okay. I will leave your reading at that though, Cappy. So thank you again for tuning in.